Hey, horse people. I didn't want to yell because the boys are eating. They'd be like, damn, he's got the camera. All right, crazy horse story. There's a little horsey back here. I don't know if you guys can see it. He's waiting for them at the meeting of the post. He's like, dude, where's my friends? They're supposed to come say hi to me this morning. They'll be over there in a minute after they finish breakfast, buddy. I don't know who lives back there. I only see one. Every once in a while, I see two horses, but I see that one little horse meeting them back there all the time. Probably ought to go knock on their door and ask them if Buddy and Mr. T can have a little sleepover. Let them come over here and play with them. Spend the day together. They'd all have fun. But anyway, I digress. Let's back in the back pasture. Let's go over here back to the boys. All right. So, let me grab my coffee here. Good morning, Texas. Sunrise coming up. Hell, someone's going to say, what time is it? I don't know. Hang on. Let me check my damn clock. Nobody carries a watch anymore. They got a damn phone. 7:13 is the time. Hi, buddy. Dad's coming up. Don't kick him. Hang on. Let me approach him. You gotta be careful back here. If you walk a horse to the rear, you have to walk up like this so he doesn't kick you. Look, don't be giving that lady any hate, all right? I'm hearing, reading the comments. Most people have been pretty nice. There's been a couple people that's calling her an idiot. Look, I don't agree with a horse training, but I don't want everybody beating her up. And it gets old and I can't control people, and you know, people come in here, but the people who come in here will go over there and hate on her and tell her she's stupid. Look, everybody makes mistakes, and there's some people, I knew it. I mean, when I did that video on that holistic training thingy, I knew there would be people here immediately defending her, and there was people. She's really good. She really knows. You just took one video. Look, maybe it was just one video. Maybe that was her first video. I'm telling you, when I get sent these videos, I do not do research. I don't go, okay, before I do this, I'm gonna go watch all their videos, and I'm gonna make sure that this is the only one that's bad, and I'm gonna try and be this great critique. Look, I'm just giving my opinion on what I thought she did wrong and a horse was confused. I'm trying to get people to develop their critical eye. So when they see people telling them this is what's happening, a lot of times in a horse world, it's not true. A lot of people don't know what they're talking about, but they're talking to people that don't know. So those people go, wow, wow. Well, if they said it and they're a horse trainer, then they must be right. I've never seen a mare in my life tilt her head. And that woman said it with such belief and honesty that there's probably thousands of people running around now going, yeah, mares talk to their horses in the herd with their head by turning it in front of them, and they stand in front so they see both their eyes, and then they make them move forward. I mean, it makes no logic. But look, don't be hating on people. I mean, that's the problem. You can't educate. I mean, on my cop channel, I'm always showing cops making mistakes and getting in shootings and things they could have done right, and I got some people coming hating on the cop. That guy should be fired. He's no good. And I got other people coming, why are you picking on cops? You were a cop. You shouldn't be making them look bad. I mean, you just can't give in a classroom environment. When I'm teaching, I can give examples and I can show things and I can communicate with people. So when I'm trying to educate online, I can't control my audience. So, you know, I don't necessarily have people that just want to learn and don't want to be mean and want to come here and find something to hate on, or find something to hate me, so they'll go and tell that woman that I'm being mean and I'm sexist, and they just want to stir up trouble. I mean, they're just miserable people, and I don't understand why horses attract them, but God, it's just so prevalent. So anyway, I digress. Let me get back to where Mr. T almost killed my ex-girlfriend. Everybody's like, oh, I'm gonna call her and tell her he's talking smack about her. I don't care. She probably didn't care either. You don't know who she is. So anyway, so I'm dating this girl, and you know, she knows I spend a lot of time on my horses. I'm always, I gotta go feed my horses, I gotta go do this, I'm going riding, I'm going things. So, and I'm keeping my horses at this other woman's house, who I used to date, but And they knew that. It wasn't like, I've got this girlfriend and I didn't tell her and I've got them both together and they didn't. They both knew. They both worked in the same. Believe me, we all knew everybody's business. It wasn't, nobody was sneaking around. So, anyway, the girl whose house I was at knows me. I mean, I am who I am. So she knows me. And so, you know, and she's smart enough. She's been around horses her whole life, etc. She's smart enough to go, I'm not riding Tanner. That horse is a little wild. He's kind of crazy. You can ride him, you know. And when I was riding one of her other horses one time, and he was bucking, and I was laughing. And she's like, Rick, I know you think that's funny, and you think that's funny, but she goes, I don't like horses bucking. I don't want to be on a horse that bucks, and you think it's funny, and you're letting it buck. I go, he's just getting out some piss and vinegar. He's not trying to, you know, and he ended up bucking me into the wall and almost killing me. But anyway, that's another story. So anyway, so she doesn't, she's not, she, I think she's more in tune with her ability, and I dated her. I know she, I usually date a little bit stronger-willed women. I don't date these little cream puff rice paper. You told me that I did something and now you're me. I can't deal with that. So anyway, so most of the women I date are kind of, you know, they're pretty spunky and cocky and they know how to take me with a grain of salt. So anyway, I digress. So, let me try and think where the hell I was at. So the horse is bucking. I forgot where the hell I was at on this damn story. But anyway, the girl that the house is staying at is smart enough to know not to ride Tanner. She just like, I don't want to ride him. And I mean, even when Buddy was bucking me sometimes, she was like, I don't know if I want to ride Buddy either. Because I let them be horses. And she likes the robotic. She ends a bit. She thinks I ought to use a bit. I was riding that horse that bucked me off with a halter. So, anyway, I bring this girl out here, and the cold's just lingering on just a little bit. It's kind of cold out here, and that damn cough, I can't get rid of it. I know everybody's going to be telling me to take this medicine. I got to be pretty sick to take medicine. I'll just let it work itself out. So anyway, she wants to meet Tanner and wants to come out and ride. She said she rode before, and I mean, this girl is, I don't know, this tall, 95 pounds. So it's not like either of my horses are going to even know she's on her back anyway. So we go out there, and I'm like, you know what? Tanner's kind of, and Tanner's got this beauty and majestic about him that, I mean, people just like him, guys and women. But he's really a good-looking horse, especially when he was in his prime, walking around all cocky and studying. When you see him in a herd with his mares and how he works it and controls it and his confidence, I mean, he's just a majestic, great horse. And I know I'm biased, whatever. So we go out there, and she sees Tanner, and she meets him and meets Buddy, and she wants to ride Tanner because he's pretty. And I'm like, man, Tanner's a little rough to handle. I said, so I tried to kind of eat, you know, without saying, because I got to be careful. You know how women can get if you say something wrong. You know, you tell them they're weak or they can't do something, and then it's like, ah, I can do anything here. So I was like being careful, trying to be tiptoe around. Look, Tanner's a little high-spirited, and I mean, well, if you can ride him, I can ride him. All right, whatever. Let's go. I'm going to put you in the round pen. I want you to understand that he rides in a rope halter. You ain't getting no bit. You know, I want you in a controlled environment. So we get in a round pen. And before she gets on him, I make him do a little few things, get a little piss and vinegar out of him. He's like, and Tanner's just, he's been around so long. I put one of my nephews on him when he was, hell, I don't know, 18 or 19. And my nephew was like, man, I want to get off him. He's just, and my nephew rode Buddy and ran. We went up and down hills and rode at night and did all this other crap. But when he got on Mr. T, Mr. T was like, okay, you want to be tough. And he was just like, holy cow, man, this horse is strong. He goes, can I get off, Uncle Rick? Because I just want to get off. I'm like, all right, yeah, get off, no problem. Because he wanted to sit on me. And as a matter of fact, I think I kind of forced him to get on because he didn't want to get on him either. I'm like, dude, you got to get on him and just feel. He's just such, you got to understand the difference between horses. You ride Buddy because he's easy and you're not as confident and you're not as well. But get on a horse that really will, like, test you. And, man, when he got on him, you know, Tanner buffed up. And you can tell, you can just feel the power. And Tanner moves, man. It's just, it's amazing. So this girl, she gets on Mr. T, and we get in a round pin. And I'm trying to talk her through, and I'm in the middle, so I can kind of help her so she doesn't have to kick it. You don't want to kick Mr. T. You're going to have problems. You kick Mr. T, you better be hanging on. So Mr. T is very light, and he's very... I mean, move the reins. If you watch some other videos, all I have to do is move the reins forward. He's ready to go. So you don't want to get on him squeezing and kicking because it's go time. So, and I told her that. So when I was in the middle, if you're in a round pen, it was easy for me to put pressure on Mr. T. Even though she was on his back, Mr. T was still paying attention to me. I could move a little bit behind that drive line, put that forward pressure. Oh, I'm sorry. I mean, get in front of him, turn my head and go, ah! So I could move behind him and get him to go forward. And then if I told her to turn and he wasn't really turning, I could move in front of that drive line, he would stop, and it would make it easier for her to turn. So I'm not sure. I'm trying to think how we got in that she wanted to run him. And I mean, I'm pretty sure she don't watch my videos. She's buried now. Nice girl, don't be hating on her. We had good times, I care about her, she's a nice girl, don't be hating on her. And I know people will be like, you tried to kill her. I didn't try to kill her, Mr. T tried to kill her. I just laughed. Woo, you laughed! I couldn't help it. I laugh when somebody gets tossed off a horse, especially when they tell me they can ride it. So anyway, somehow she starts feeling a little confident, she's turning, she's got it, I'm in the middle. And again, I'm thinking, I'm not trying to give this story wrong, but I think she was just like, I got it now, I don't need your help, kind of, I got it. Because she turned him and moved him and all that. And I went, all right. So I don't remember, I think I was still in the middle. I might have been on the side. I don't remember whether I stayed in the middle or I was on the side, but she turned Mr. T a couple times and got her confidence up and felt like, yeah, I am woman. She's like, I'm going to make him run. I was like, got to be careful. Once he starts running, you got, you know, and I'm trying to, you know, when you're telling people things, you got to kind of try to be a little tight. That's why I'm not real good with working with people, because I don't like playing that tactful. I'm just like, hey, don't be a dummy. He's going to toss your ass on the ground. That's what I would have wanted said. If you get out there and be stupid and you try to be tough and you try to show him who's boss, your ass going to end up on the ground. Rick, you're mean. You don't know how to talk to people. You should be nice. Oh, whatever. So anyway, I'm trying to be nice and smooth talk it and not be mean and not get in trouble and not embarrass her and not have my other ex-girlfriend call me, why are you being an ass, Rick? Like, look, man. So I'm in the middle here of all this, and I don't want Mr. T to learn a bad lesson. I don't want Mr. T to hurt nobody, and I don't want Mr. T to, you know, get yanked to her or get in trouble. So how we got to her running, I cannot remember. But I remember Mr. T was running. And I remember that look on her face was like, holy shit. And Mr. T just started running. And I don't know if she was trying to turn it or trying to stop him. But Mr. T, when he figures out that he's kind of in control and you're not really driving anymore and he's got some dummy on his back, man, he's good at dumping people. He didn't buck and throw her off. Mr. T does this, I'm running really fast, and I'm gonna turn a couple times, and I'm gonna feel you off balance, and as soon as I feel you off balance, whichever way you're leaning, I'm turning the opposite way, and you're gonna hit the ground. And he's done it to me, he's done it to other people. Let me tell you, he's a master at it. So, He runs some way, she either turns it, I can't remember if it was into the fence, out of the fence. It's kind of a little blurry because when she hit the ground, I was kind of like, oh shit, that's not good. So, and then she didn't move, so I was like, well, that's not good. And then I got in trouble because I didn't go over and help her because I went after Mr. T to try to stop him. So, but anyway, so she turns or does something and Mr. T, and she gets a little off balance. And then Mr. T just feels her going to the side, and he is really circling now, like, yeah, hang on, you want to ride? Come on, let's go, tough girl. And I'm like, oh, shit. I was like, you got to pull him, you got it. And she wasn't hearing nothing. You could just tell she kind of went into vapor lock. I'm falling off. I'm scared. This horse is going fast. I'm out of control. She wasn't hearing nothing, and I couldn't really do nothing. I don't think I was inside because I think I could have stopped him. But it sounds like it went on for a long time, but it happened pretty quick. So anyway, somehow she ends up, when he turns or stops or takes a quick turn, she ends up kind of flying into the middle of the rail. I can't remember how, but I know she landed kind of in the middle of the round pen, face first. Bam! And the round pen was kind of chewed up dirt. It was soft. It wasn't hard, hard ground. I get it when you fall off a horse, but hell, she's only 100 pounds. This shit is almost like a leaf falling. But anyway, so she hits the ground. A little puff of dust, poof. I'm trying to get a visual here, poof. No noise, she doesn't move. She's face down. I might have heard one grunt. Ooh, I might have heard that. I'm not sure. I know I'm gonna get hate on this. Oh, shut up, quit it. I wasn't laughing like that then. I was a little worried about her, but I knew she was all right. She looked okay. No, she didn't have a helmet. Nobody owned helmets or had helmets, shit. We rode horses. So, anyway, Mr. T, after he gets off, he's all jacked up, driving around. I run over to grab Mr. T. So I'm like, dude, I gotta calm him down. He's kind of upset. And so my other ex-girlfriend is like, Rick, why don't you leave the horse alone and go check on her? And I'm like, oh, okay. She had to bring me back to reality. I know her. You're such an asshole. You don't care about more of your heart. Whatever. Jesus Christ. She just fell on some dirt. It's not like she was dead. She wasn't moving, but I knew she wasn't dead. I just saw the fall. It might have been a big fall to her. It wasn't way up in the air coming down and hitting and getting dragged. And I mean, he's in a round pen. He couldn't go that fast. Mr. T can go pretty fast. And she hit the ground and made a little dust puff, but she was all right. So I go over, I'm rubbing her, brushing the dust and cobwebs off her. You okay, you okay? So after, she didn't move, she didn't say anything. But I could tell looking at her eyes, she was just kind of like, oh shit, that sucked. So I get her up, she gets up, we dust her off, everything's cool. I give her a hug and, you know, my hugs pretty much heal everything. So, he's so cocky and arrogant, he treats me. Shut up, you big dummies. So, we get up, she's okay, and I'm like, don't be mad at Mr. T. He didn't mean to. Mr. T's over there like, who's next? Who wants to get up? Because he's just a horse. He wasn't trying to hurt her. He wasn't trying to kill her. He wasn't, you got to remember, Mr. T, they were going to kill him when I got him. He used to be ridden in a big bit. I'll try to find a bit, and maybe I'll try to stick it in here. I mean, it was just tie down, bit, long shanks. He was this taught to be really aggressive horse and to fight with people. So, but he wasn't, I mean, I had had him for a while, but he still had that kind of, you know, he could go back to that in a snap. Even to this day, when they were doing my roof and the guys were talking Spanish, man, Mexicans did all that, cut him, did all those things to him. I tell them a story about him. So even a day when he hears somebody speak in Spanish, he's like, he gets a little puffy. He doesn't want to be around them. He's like, I know this fight. I know when somebody talks to me like that, I usually get hurt and it was painful and, you know, it was brutal and I was beat or whatever. So people are going to say he's racist. He can't be racist. He's black. Quit with all that PC BS. Mr. T's black. He can't be racist. So anyway, but he don't like Mexicans. So anyway, and he doesn't like all Mexicans. I dated a Mexican girl, he liked her fine, but whatever. So he's just that type of horse that if he feels anxiety or something going wrong, I mean, even with me today, if I get excited around him, he'll be like, you know, if I get on his back and I wanna, if I was yelling, there was one time I had to go, some guy's trying to steal a horse and me and Mr. T had to run up there and grab him, man, he knows when something's up. So that was the story of me and Mr. T and one of my exes. That sun came right up in that thing, didn't it? Hell, I don't know if y'all can see the horses anymore. this over here, sunrise went and popped up on me, and hell, yeah, they're still around. Not quite the bad shadow. So, I mean, that's just one of those things that lessons are learned. Could it have been done better? I don't know. I mean, she wanted to ride, and I kind of told her and gave her all the warnings, and she's a damn adult, and she made the decision to do it, and I went okay. And, you know, yeah, if she'd broke her neck and died, I'd have probably felt bad, but I didn't think Mr. T was going to, like, stomp on her or buck her, and he didn't. He just ran fast, turned, she lost her balance, she didn't realize the power he had, and ended up hitting the ground. And it was really nobody's fault. It definitely wasn't Mr. T's fault, by no means. If it was anybody's fault, it was me or her or my other ex-girlfriend that didn't have sense to stop it. So blame her if you're going to blame me. Anyway, so that's the story of Mr. T dumping. I can't think of the other people. Buddy dumped one girl. I wasn't dating her, but she was like wanting to ride Buddy and thought he was so nice. And I was like, he's in a bucky mood. He's going to toss you off. No, he won't. You always say that. He's such a... I go, okay, get on him. Buddy ran across the thing, bucked her ass off. It was pretty funny. Maybe I'll do another story on her. But anyway, that's the story of Mr. T trying to mess up my relationship, kill my girlfriend. It's probably why we're not together. It ain't his fault. Good grief. All right, Buddy, Mr. T, you're good boys. Your little friend's still out there waiting? He is. Poor little guy. He's like, where's my friends? How come you guys aren't coming out here to say good morning to me? Oh, he's waiting like a good little horsey. Maybe I'll feed the guys out there tomorrow so they can eat with him. He'll have a little buddy to stand with. I fed the cows and the donkey on the other side. They're already over there eating. All right, well, in that there. Texas morning, good sunrise, little playmate horsey coming over to see the boys. And actually, Buddy plays with this guy more. I don't know if he thinks he's another Mr. T or whatever. Mr. T just goes out there and kind of acts like, I'm the leader, I don't have to play with you. And Buddy's like over the fence. They're doing the neck and the head thing. Cows are out over here too. What are you guys doing over here? Surprised they ain't over here trying to get a free meal. All right, well, in that there.